So in this lesson, we're talking about multiplying and dividing integers. But before we can do that effectively, we need to make sure we go over the rules for multiplying and dividing integers. Now the rules are the same for both multiplication and division. Also remember that integers are whole numbers that are positive, negative, or zero. So if the numbers that we're multiplying or dividing have the same sign, then that means the answer will be positive. So if we're multiplying two numbers that are both negative, because those signs are the same, our answer will be positive. If we're multiplying two numbers where they're both positive, the answer will still be positive, because both numbers have the same sign. And if the integers have different signs, then that means the answer is going to be negative. So if one number is positive and one number is negative, then our answer will be negative. And that's because the signs of the numbers we're multiplying or dividing are different. So let's take a look at our first example. Here we have 5 times negative 7. The first number we have is 5. And that's a positive value because there's no sign at all. And the second number we have is negative 7, which is negative. Are these signs the same or are they different? Well, this one's positive and this one's negative. Therefore, the signs are different, which means that our answer is going to be negative. And what's 5 times 7? Well, that's 35. So our answer will be negative 35. Here's our next example. Negative 24 divided by negative 2. Our first number is a negative, and our second number is also a negative. And this means that our signs are the same. And because our signs are the same, that means our answer will be positive. And what's 24 divided by 2? Well, that's going to be 12. And again, it's positive because the numbers that we're dividing have the same sign. They're both negative. So this might look a little bit different, but this just means negative 6 times 8. Our first number is a negative, and our second number is a positive. And that means that our signs are different. And because our signs are different, that means our answer is going to be negative. And what's 6 times 8? Well, that's 48. But again, since our signs are different, it's not just 48, it's negative 48. So this one looks a little bit different too. But remember, when you have numbers represented as a fraction, this also represents division. So we've got two numbers here. Our first number is negative 50, which is a negative. And our second number is 5, which is a positive. And that means that the signs of our numbers that we're using are different. And since the signs are different, that means our answer is going to be negative. And what's 50 divided by 5? That's 10. But remember, it's not just 10 here, but negative 10. In this example, we've got negative 7 times negative 8. Our first sign is negative, our second sign is negative, and since our signs are the same, that means our answer will be positive. And what's 7 times 8? Well, that's 56. So our answer is positive 56. And here's our last example. This one's a little bit tricky. A lot of my students would look at this and they would say, well, our first number is negative and this one's negative and the last one's negative, which means they're all the same. And our answer is gonna be positive. I'm sorry to tell you, but that is Wrong. The reason why it's wrong is because you have to remember that these rules only apply when you multiply two numbers at a time. So we'll start with -3 times -8. And those two numbers have signs that are the same or different. Well, they're the same. And since they're the same, the result from multiplying these numbers will be positive. And what's 3 times 8? Well, that's 24. And remember, it's positive because the numbers that we were multiplying had the same sign. So we've got positive 24 and negative 2. But these signs are different. And since these signs are different, our answer is going to be negative. And 24 times 2 is 48. So therefore, our answer will be negative 48. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time on the Math Review.